I'm John Gruccio, and this is Movie Man's Corner. On today's show, we'll be looking at my recent adventure to the first ever Wizard World Comic Con in the great music city of the world, Nashville, Tennessee. From the meeting of childhood heroes to the sights and sounds of amazing fans, I can say that it truly was a great time in Nashville. I will show you my coverage of the event later on in the show, but now it is time for the latest and greatest in movie news. We all loved him in such great films as The Blues Brothers and Animal House, and we especially loved him in his oddball bits on SNL. I am, of course, talking about the famous John Belushi. For most of us who know, Belushi tragically died at the age of 33 from a drug overdose, leaving this world way too soon. For years now, studios have been trying to get his story onto the big screen. I can say now that there is an actual glimmer of hope that this will happen. A biography based off a recent book published by Belushi's widow is coming to theaters soon. The film will show Belushi after he was already famous and then his slow decline with drugs. As of now, actor Emil Hirsch is set to play Belushi with first-time director Steve Conrad up to direct the film. The film should start filming next spring. She called me Mr. Bombastic, friendly fantastic, puts me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Roe. Monty, on me fantastic, puts me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Roe. Smooth. Just like a silk, soft and cuddly, hug me up like a quilt. I'm a lyrical lover, now take me thin and filled with my sexual physique. You know me well, Bill, do me, oh my, well, can't you tell? I'm just like a turtle crawling out of my shell. Bill Murray, another SNL alum who we all have loved and have been missing terribly in the cinemas, is coming back. He is set to star in 2015's animated adventure, Boo, Bureau of Otherworldly Operations, alongside Seth Rogen and Melissa McCarthy. The film follows the world's greatest counter-haunting force as they take on the world's greatest ghost. Murray is set to play the film's villain, a ghost by the name of Addison Drake. The film is being distributed by DreamWorks Animation, the distributors of such films as How to Train Your Dragon and The Croods. For those of you Sons of Anarchy fans, the show's creator Kurt Sutter is gaining a little bit of momentum on his longtime boxing drama script, Southpaw. Sutter drafted a script for this film almost around the same time Sons of Anarchy was first aired. For a while, Eminem was set to star in the film, but has since forth left the project. Now, rumor is that actor Jake Gyllenhaal, who was most notable this year in his performance in Prisoners, is being courted for the role. With Training Day director Antoine Fuqua up to direct the film, this could be a film to really keep your eye on. The film follows a left-handed prize fighter that wins a title but then is soon struck with tragedy in his life. He must then pick up the pieces of his life and get back on track. Now, ladies and gents, boys and girls, the time has come for me to show you Wizard World Nashville. Book fans have invaded the Music City capital of the world. From Superman to Doctor Who, fans have come in masses to the convention in their best costumes to meet their favorite celebrities of both film and comic book fame.
At this year's con, there were such celebrities as Norman Reedus and Chandler Riggs, who play Daryl Dixon and Carl Grimes off of AMC's hit Walking Dead, Stan the Man Lee, a comic book legend in the field, Ray Park, who played Darth Maul in Star Wars Episode I, The Phantom Menace. On the flip side, artists and writers such as Neil Adams, artist of such comics as Batman and Green Lantern, Greg Horn, artist for Marvel War of Heroes, and Mike Grell, a writer and artist for such series as Green Arrow and Green Lantern, were in attendance as well. I was able to sit down with Mr. Grell and ask him some questions about the convention and his work.
Sir, could you tell me just, are you enjoying the con so far?
Yes, I am, and I'm enjoying Nashville. I've driven through here, but that was, you know, just on a highway trip about 40 years ago. The town's changed ever so slightly, but it's an amazing city. I'm really loving it.
I know that you're famous for Green Arrow, but could you tell us like some of the other comics that you've been famous for? I mean, that you've worked on.
Sure. Back in the early days, I did Superboy and the Legion of Superheroes. I've done projects of my own, such as The Warlord, Sable, John Sable Freelance, which became a short-lived TV series on ABC in the 87-88 season. I was the artist who did the first the first graphic novels of the James Bond, called Permission to Die. I'm the guy who revealed Iron Man's secret identity. So I've been around for a while. I've worked on tons and tons of different books, X-Men and things like that.
Now with all of these books, and I know most of them in this day and age have either gotten movies or TV shows, like I know Green Arrow has had some animated movies, and now the second season of the show on CW has started. Have you noticed or have you been asked for like any advice on any of these shows?
Well, unfortunately, they don't consult with me, but they're very cool guys. The producers and the writers of the show seem to go to extra pains to give credit where credit is due. They mention my name every now and then. They use me for a villain, Judge Grell. My niece phoned me up and said, "Uncle Mike, you're famous." I said, "Honey, I've been famous for 40 years. You just never noticed." And then she wanted to know if they had to pay me to use the name. Unfortunately, no. Dang it.
Do you have any upcoming projects or comics that you're working on?
Yes, as a matter of fact, right now I'm working on a special project for Dark Horse Comics. For Dark Horse Presents, I'm doing Tarzan. Yeah, it's a return to the old days. I did the Tarzan comic strip in the Sunday papers from 81 to 83. So it's like going home again.
Just as a final question, I'm kind of overwhelmed because I'm a huge fan of Green Lantern and Green Arrow. Do you have any advice for any aspiring artists?
Advice for aspiring artists? Sure. Learn to draw something besides comics. You see, well, cartoonists have a tendency to focus all their drawing on what they see in comic books. You should be a good artist to begin with and be as diverse as possible. Stay up with the trends, learn how to use Photoshop, learn how to do it with digital art because it's the wave of the future. I'm an analog guy, still using my pencil, but I've actually in the last few years learned to do stuff digitally as well. And you have to stay ahead of the trend so that you can be a trendsetter instead of a trend follower.
As a teenager of the 90s, one of my personal favorite films was in fact Troy Duffy's vigilante film, The Boondock Saints.
Our feet may swiftly carry out their command, so we shall flow river forth to thee, and taming the soul shall it ever be. And when your patriot feeling, spirit is sanct.
At the convention this year, the original three stars of the film were in attendance: Sean Patrick Flannery, Norman Reedus, and David Della Rocco. I was only able to interview the funny man himself, Rocco, which, believe me, was a delight. I asked Mr. Della Rocco a little bit about some upcoming projects he's had and his thoughts on the original film.
Mr. Della Rocco, just a couple questions for you. First off, I'm a huge fan of the Boondock Saints. I loved you in 1 and even 2. My first question would be, I know that you and Troy Duffy, the director of Boondock Saints, are pretty good friends. Do you guys have any other projects in store other than possibly a Boondock Saints 3?
Well, Troy's working on a TV series about a pirate, and he's also writing Boondock 3, and he should be getting on it pretty soon. I just came out with a film, Dead in Five Heartbeats, and that's that. But yeah, Boondock 3 should be within a year and a half, either ready or, you know, well into production.
Will there be any chance we'll see the funny man in Boondock Saints 3?
I don't know. I don't think so. I'm dead.
I've heard that you're a member of the Actors Studio. Can you tell me a little bit about this, and did this help you get your role in Boondock Saints?
No, it didn't. It was just something that I was studying. I started at the Strasbourg, started studying with a woman, Susan Peretz, who was from that school, and she was an Actor Studio member. So I just tried out for it. You know, auditioned for it, I'm sorry. And, you know, that was that. But I don't go there anymore.
Was it nerve-wracking on the set of Boondock Saints? Because I heard for a long time there was a lot of big names attached to it.
No, not on the set. Maybe it was nerve-wracking waiting for it to happen. But once we got on set, it was an independent film. Nobody bothered us. Troy could do anything he wanted, within the budget, that is.
As I mentioned before, one of the biggest sights of the con is in fact the fans who are in costume. These fans are also known as cosplayers. I spoke with a certain cosplayer by the name of House Cosplay, who really went the extra effort with his costume.
One of the best things about coming to Wizard World or Comic Con is seeing the fans dress up. I'm here with House Cosplay, and he has become the Hulk in the most truest form I have seen. It is just amazing. Can you tell us a little bit about like how this came up, how you made this costume?
Yeah, it's all polyfoam. I use a glue called Teclin by a company called Torsen. Like, it's not even sold in the United States. I have to import it from the UK. And what it'll do is when you sculpt these pieces out and you get ready to make your pattern and put them together, it'll become foam as it dries. So it'll actually bind, and you won't have seams like a lot of these other mascots will. Other than that, it's just making a custom pattern and then building it up from there, and you just resize it for what size you want. For Hulk, I really wanted to go big. I really wanted to give people that dramatic sense when you see it walking down, that there's a 5-foot-wide person walking at you. And it's not something I've ever seen done before, and I mean, everybody loves the Hulk. So why wouldn't you want to bring that to Wizard World Comic Con, especially if it's the first one? I mean, it's our first year. You definitely want to bring out the good stuff.
Now, I think you mentioned this earlier with Lou Ferrigno, the original Hulk, of course. Did you meet him?
I have met Lou Ferrigno here today. He was very kind. He really enjoyed the costume. It's about the only way that I was ever going to get as big as him was polyfoam. It really was my best friend in this. All the muscle detailing on the abs, it's airbrush. We do that after the fact, and like sometimes the glue will seep through, and it just looks like more detailing. Nobody knows that you messed up. It's more ab detail.
So that's not like all natural through the foam.
I mean, it is mostly body paint, but there is some foam in here.
why? I'm guessing was the Hulk your first choice this year?
No. I chose the Hulk because he's just been near and dear to my heart for a long time. My favorite is Iron Man. Before the movies, I've been reading them since the 90s. It's just after the movies, you can't do an Iron Man costume. There's a million of them running around, and I like to be unique. And I was like, Hulk is something I can do in a way that other people don't do Hulk. And it really, like, to me, that's what it's all about.
Now, I know that you said earlier when we were talking that you've been dressing up each day, right? What are some of the other costumes that you've worn and some of the ones that you're going to wear?
I was a Tennessee Ghostbuster yesterday, part of the club. I was a Link from Wind Waker. It's also like a big foam head, so it looks like the character, because he's got kind of a 30% like head-to-body ratio. I'll be doing Goku from Dragon Ball Z. Now, that's a big one for me, because like, he is like the Japanese Superman. He is the epitome of like what a powerful character is in Japan. And that was my first costume, and I've just been upgrading it year after year. So he's going to be out here today, as well as Link will come back again today.
Okay. I know that you said you're a cosplayer. Is this something that you're just, is it necessarily just a professional hobby? Is this something that you're really into?
I would say I'm really into it, because I normally spend about, you know, $600 per costume. I know the average is like, we go to Goodwill and just spit something out, and it usually looks really good. But for me, like, I do commit a lot of my time and money into this. I do IT for Amazon on a normal basis, so people only call me when stuff's broke. So when I'm cosplaying, like, they're not yelling at me about their computer not working. They're just telling me, hey, you look awesome, or maybe you don't look so awesome. Either way, it's better than the IT stuff. Hulk smash!
In the 1980s, four men asked us the pivotal question, who you gonna call? That's right, the Ghostbusters. At the con, I met members of the Kentucky and Tennessee Ghostbusters who told me about their time there and also let me become an unofficial Ghostbuster.
Well, I'm here with the Tennessee Ghostbusters at Wizard World. Guys, are you enjoying the con?
Absolutely, we're having a fantastic time out here.
Now, what exactly are you guys doing here today?
Well, we're actually teamed up with West Kentucky Ghostbusters. We're a local fan group. We costume as the Ghostbusters from the movies. We've teamed up with a Western Kentucky group. We're collecting some donations for the Kentucky Children's Hospital. Just hanging out and having a good time, letting people come by, try on the uniform, try on some of the equipment, that sort of thing. Just having fun.
Now, are you actually like particular roles like Dan Aykroyd, Harold Ramis, or?
No, actually, we're ourselves. We're just ourselves if we were Ghostbusters, if we'd pursued a different career path. Now, we get told all the time that this guy looks a lot like Dan Aykroyd.
I mean, that's a compliment, though.
Yeah,
he's a funny guy.
He's one of my heroes, you know. We got Ernie Hudson here, another hero. We loved the movie growing up, and so we're hoping for a third one.
Well, I know, speaking of Ernie Hudson, one of you guys told me that you actually got to meet Ernie Hudson?
Oh, yeah, we've met Ernie several times, but today he came over to our booth, and we all went up on the stage over there and got a big group photo together. Ernie's he's a great guy. He's really good to the fans. He's awesome. He really is.
Do you guys have any predictions for Ghostbusters 3? You think we'll see it in the next coming years?
It's hit or miss for us. We would love to. We would obviously love to see it. You know, they have an IMDb. Page, and we're hoping for it. I'll just put it that way.
If you guys, because I know that they've said that there's gonna be new cast members, who would you guys love to see as the new cast?
Well, us right here.
Yeah, I think
Mike and Mike and Ronning and.
What's the coolest story you've gotten so far? I know something about. I know you've got the picture of Viggo behind you.
Oh yeah.
Have you had any like really any really fun stories other than Ernie Hudson?
Well, we went out last night. A bunch of us guys went out last night in costume, walked down Broadway here in Nashville. It was a blast. I mean, we were like rock stars walking out through there. I mean, it must be what like Sting feels like, or, you know, something like that. It was, well, maybe better than
the
Sting.
Oh, the Eagles were here. I don't know. The Eagles were here just a week ago. So
it's true, true.
Nashville is awesome.
Yeah,
Broadway downtown,
city.
We love it. Everybody came out. We took pictures. Great city. We love it. A lot of us live here, and it was just cool to go down Broadway and see the reactions. People really love it, love the film, the franchise uniforms, and that's what it's about, having fun, entertaining, and something different. So we had a blast.
The kids love us.
Yeah.
Just the kids love us.
Drunk people also really love
yeah,
us.
Yeah, yes, they really love you. Oh,
yeah,
oh, hey.
They help us field test.
Yes, yes, exactly.
We're ready to believe you.
Well, if you can't already tell, this is definitely a place you need to be if you love movies and or comics. The next con in Nashville will be in September of next year. On the next show, I will show you the rest of my time at Wizard World Nashville. Movie Man out. As a huge fan of both comics and film, I know I for one had a blast at this year's con. And of course, one of my bucket list moments was finally captured as I was able to meet my own personal hero, Mr. Stan the Man Lee, the Overlord Supreme of Marvel Comics. I mean, I shook the man's hand. It was truly a defining moment. Now, as the movie man, one of my main goals is to entice you with fantastic and awesome trailers for films coming out soon, and this week will blow your minds. But you will just have to wait and see what I have in store for you in this week's segment
of coming soon to theaters.
Coming up on the drop zone, Cap.
You do anything fun Saturday night?
Well, all the guys in my barbershop quartet are dead, so... No, not really.
You know, if you ask Kristen out from statistics, she'd probably say yes.
That's why I don't ask.
Too shy or too scared?
Too busy! Was he wearing a parachute?
No. No, he wasn't.
I joined SHIELD to protect people.
Captain,
to build a better world,
sometimes means tearing the old one down. And that makes enemies.
Are you ready for the world to see you as you really are? Look out the window. You know how the game works. Disorder, war. All it takes is one step.
We're gonna neutralize a lot of threats before they even happen.
Thought the punishment usually came after the crime.
SHIELD takes the world as it is, not as we'd like it to be.
This isn't freedom. This is fear.
You need to keep both eyes open.
Before we get started, does anyone want to get out? Your work has been a gift to mankind. You've shaped the century. I need you to do it one more time.
Gear up. It's time.
Wake up in my young body, and then what?
Find me. Convince me of all of this. It's going to take the two of us.
And where do I find you?
A different path. A darker path.
Logan, I was a very different man. Lead me. Guide me. Be patient with me. Patience isn't my strongest suit.
I don't want your suffering. I don't want your future.
Totally awesome trailers, right?
I mean, you got Captain America, he's in the modern world now, and now taking on an unknown enemy who is from his past. And of course, you got Robert Redford, man. This movie just screams that it's going to just be epic. And then, not to leave out X-Men Days of Future Past, because they are my favorite. I mean, the simple fact that you see James McAvoy and Patrick Stewart in the same scene, it's just, it blew my mind. But for all of you fans of those trailers, you won't have to wait long. Captain America the Winter Soldier will be released in theaters on April 4th, and X-Men Days of Future Past will be coming almost a month later on May 23rd. The Return of an Avenger comes out this week to theaters. For a closer look at his return, let's transition to this week's segment of This Week in Theaters. Thor: The Dark World stars Chris Hemsworth, Natalie Portman, Tom Hiddleston, Jamie Alexander, Christopher Eccleston, and Anthony Hopkins. The film is directed by Alan Taylor and is rated PG-13 for sequences of intense sci-fi action and some suggestive content. It will be released in 2D, 3D, and IMAX 3D theaters across the country. If you are a Murray, Kentucky resident, be sure to check out this film at the Cherie Theater located on Chestnut Street. That's all for this week on The Movie Man's Corner. Be sure to check us out on Facebook and Twitter. I'm John the Movie Man Gruccio, and remember, if you have a question about a movie, then think no further, because I'm the man to see. Good night.